this is a pressure cooker. You would find this in almost every kitchen in India or all throughout the world. And according to me, this is one of the best inventions that cooking science has ever created. How do we use a pressure cooker? We use it for cooking many things, rice, grams, beans, vegetables. So let me show you. You first put all the vegetables. Then you add some water. And then you can add some salt. Okay. And then even to close it, you know, you need a technique. I remember two of my friends who couldn't close a pressure cooker, and they opened YouTube and they were seeing how to close a pressure cooker. Okay. So it is a bit complicated, but it's one of the best tools. What are the key elements we put in? We put in some vegetables and we put a water. Okay. So if you see the mechanism of pressure cooker, water is the key element. Water is the one that produces steam, and that steam produces pressure, which in turn lets the vegetables to cook. Okay. And then there are many other parts, and through this nozzle the steam comes out. Okay. And from down we create the flame and we give the heat and it gets cooked. Okay. Now we understood the pressure cooker. This God pressurizes. Do we go through a pressure cooker experience in life? Yes. Why? In James 1:12, God says, "Blessed is the man that stands steadfast during the time of trial, for he has stood the test and he shall receive the crown of life." God allows us to go through some pressure because that is the criteria for us to receive the crown of life. So, what is this pressure? How do we undergo the pressure? So imagine God is the cook and we are the veggies, okay, the vegetable that I put inside. Now the water is compared to the trials, the problems that we have in our life. So those problems create the steam in our lives, which in turn cooks us, or which in turn makes us mature man and mature woman. Okay? So the steam comes out. The steam is produced and it comes out. Similarly, problems come in our life and then they go away also. But it, just like it helps cook the vegetables, it helps make us better people. God is the cook. He regulates the temperature. He will never allow us to suffer more than what we can bear. Okay, He says, "My grace is sufficient for thee." In 1 Corinthians, He says that. So God will not allow us to bear more than what we can, to suffer more than what we can bear. Do we find people in the Bible who went through pressure like this? We know Job, Joseph, Moses. Let's see the story of Joseph. He had pressure from his brothers. None of his brothers liked him. Then he was taken as a slave, okay, all alone, far from family. Then there, in that place, when he finally got a job, the owner's wife, she tempted him, and then again he was thrown in jail. Again he was in jail. Lot of pressure. He went through a lot of pressure in life, but then he stood the test. He did not sin during all this time. He did not sin, and in turn all this pressure helped him develop and become a better individual. Okay, similarly with us, especially humans, all of us, we go through a lot of pressure in life. As a woman, you may have to wake up early, okay? You have to cook for your children. You have to sometimes take care of your old parents, okay? Your parents may be old. You have to take care of them. You have to take care of your children. You have to maintain the house. You have to cook food. You have to keep it clean. You have to go to your work. You have to teach your students, or you have to work in the hospital, or you have to work with the computer. There is a lot of work that you have to do. As a man, you have to provide for your family. You have to bring things. You have to see that you manage with the money for your children's fees. And we have lots of pressure. As students, we have assignments to do. We have a lot of things to study. We need exams, entrance exams to clear. Okay, we all go through a lot of pressure. But amidst all this, what we must remember is that we need to go through this pressure so that we will come out cooked, refined and good. That is, that we come out as mature Christians. When we go through small pressure, okay, just like the problem comes and goes. Similarly, when we go through all this, it will help us to develop to be good individuals. So right now also, if you see in the world, we all are going through a major crisis, major time of trouble. Don't let this scare you. Don't let this pull you down. Rather, let it draw you closer to God. This is the best time. Spend time with God and may this experience of pressure, may this time of trouble, crisis help you to come out as a better, refined individual who is strong and close to God. Thank you.